Ho ho ho. Merry Christmas, everyone. Happy New Year as well. I know you kind of don't know when you're going to be watching this. I've released it. Oh, yeah, baby. Why am I shifting about here? I've released this before Christmas so that you'll have a chance to kind of get the beers if they're any good. And avoid the beers if they're not. Right? I've got the cat playing here again. I'm going to smack her. Bleeding. Do you know what? I ain't getting a turkey. I'm having roasted cat. Paxo. Stuffing. You. And relax. Right. Every time I start getting on the camera, she's like, ha 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 ha. Something naughty to be done. It takes after me for some reason. Right. First one I've already done is Thwaites OMG, Old Miserable Git. 4.1 ABV, not particularly Christmassy, but not a bad one, not a bad sessionable beer. Bits kind of dry bitter on the finish, almost metallic on the finish, but I kind of like that. It was had a nice dry end to it, scraped up the palate, not bad. But whether how it would do with Christmas dinner, I don't know. I'd have it kind of during the day, so you know, while I'm cooking the Christmas dinner. While I'm cooking the cat, roasted pussy cat. The other ones I've got. Let's work with the ones I'm going away from first. I'm going to go in this direction. I think I might have that one last because a 7. Sent that one, and I'm gonna have that one second last. Right, so the last one I'm going first. St. Peter's, quite old brewery and everything else. Love the bottles, they're kind of like medicine shaped bottles, and Christmas ale, and that is 7%. So I'm looking forward to that. That's that one. Get on with it, Tom. These are just a few I've got out of Tesco's. Now, I'm not enjoying Tesco's lately, but I went in there and you know what? I think they're starting to buck their ideas up a little bit. Oh, that is stuck out then. Sticking out all the time. No wonder my head looks wonky. Must be my hair on wonky or something. I've got my wig on wonky. I think it's old age. The ears starting to stick out. Doesn't matter. I ain't gonna get any prettier, am I? You know. Blitzen, this one. Do 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 no Blitzen. And this is Black Sheep Ale. Black Sheep's thing, and it's Ruby Christmas Ale. It said Santa approved on the back, and all that says. Don't know what that says. A collaboration with Blitzen the Reindeer. This beer has Santa's official approval. This cheeky festive... Sorry. Right. And finally, this is one I'm doing now. This is Hardy and Hanson's Rockin' Robin. Rockin' Robin. Oh, Rockin' Robin, gonna be the moon. Don't know the words, but it's Rockin' Reindeer there with his Elvis-y type of quiffy hairstyle, isn't it? You know, and his RR medallion. Full body turn, I ain't going to read that. That says it on the back as well, and that's about all it says. As soon as I see taste descriptions, I kind of drift off, because I don't like to have preconceived ideas of what the beer's going to be like. Apart from that, best before... And then it says best before in about a million different languages without any ingredient list. Not that I can see. Why beers don't have an ingredient list, I don't know. Something someone said about FDA and some other things and all that, but... And these ain't governed, beer ain't governed by the FDA and it, but why you have to have a beer, legally you have to have an ingredient list on chew sweets, penny chew sweets, not on beer, and not on like whiskies and things like that, that, you know, might cost you £100 or something like that. It's ridiculous, you know. Anyway, I do digress. It's been looked after, so I don't care if it's in a clear bottle or not. It's in a clear bottle, but it's been looked after by moi. I've gone and took it. I've taken it from the back of the shelf. Do that yourself as well. Shouldn't have said that, really. There's me bottle opener. If you look after your beers, they will pay you back. They'll look after you. So keep them stood upright in a cold or a cool, dark place. One that don't get extreme changes in temperatures or anything like that. Don't stick them next to your oven. Don't do stupid stuff putting them within sight of your window and everything else. And so if they can see the window, right? The window can see them, sunlight can see them. And sunlight will make them go a bit farty. Not all beers though. Depends on, you know, hops and everything else. Isomerized and whatever. So let's get on with this. Humulins and free radicals and whatever. A lot of science involved. It ain't just light equals skunky, clear equals skunky, and all that. You know, sorry, but there you go. Let's pour this on camera if I can. Hardy Hardy, Lauren Hardy and Lo Danson's, and all that. This is Hardy and Hanson's. I ain't pouring a lot in. Don't want to pour a lot in. I'm going to try and put that down somewhere. I'll get, here we go. Over there. There we go. Right. Now let's see how we got here. It looks nice. Bit dirty on the old glass there, sorry about that. I had mittens all over it. But if I tip it away from you, you can see the carbonation, nice and gradual, nice and small, nice and gentle. You can see that the stuff is holding on there, it's doing its own thing, it looks fairly natural. Let's twist it around, it's making its way down the glass. Doing all nice natural looking things. If it's like glue stuck to the glass, you kind of go, alright. If it's a meringue head and you do that to it, you go, oh really? I'm not, you know, depends, you know. It's not always the case. But anyway, big ruby sort of colour into it, ruby mahogany, that sort of thing, polished mahogany. Let's have a sniff and see what I can bring out for you. Smells kind of that session sort of thing, that EKG hops, Golding's EKGs, them sort of things. The old triumvirate, maybe a bit of Fuggles and stuff like that. You've got a little hints of orange. You know, possibly a little bit of something like a crystal malt sort of idea, and that sort of caramel. But you got a little bit of orange, a little bit of toast, a little bit of almost burnt toast, quite well done toast, unbuttered and that, you know. Where you still get that sort of edge going on. Little yeasty notes, nice little earthy notes, nice little kind of when you're getting potato skin boats, them little head, little shell thing, that dirty little earthy note to it. Nice though, nice. Smells very session beer sort of idea. It doesn't smell of Christmas, you know. It doesn't, you know. I think sometimes just stamp a label on Christmas and try a beer out. You know, we're gonna try it out, see how it goes, see if people like it. And I think that might be the case here as well. It's got. On the nose, it kind of just smells session beer in it. It smells nice, it smells good and good and quality and everything else, but it just smells session. Let's get nice, get another one down. It's not like Christmas, just treat yourself to something special. Get something to go with all them big puddingy and big, you know, all them big flavours around the Sunday roast and the Christmas roast dinner and everything, you know. Right, anyway, I've been talking too much. Let's get drop of this down. Cheers, everyone. Merry Christmas. Bottoms up, chin chin. Salute and everything else. Cheers. It's nice. That's a nice, just a nice drinkable beer. Same sort of notes on the palate as the aromas, with a little bit of maybe the hints of currant and things like that. But it's not big. It's not bolstrous and that. It's not bolstrous. It's not bolstered and boisterous and that. You know, it's not that buxom thing that you expect from Christmas beer and that. You know. If you want a Christmas beer, a good Christmas beer, get Ale Mary. Ale Mary. As in A-L-E. Ale Mary. I can't remember who does it, but it's a lovely, lovely beer. It's quite kind of mulled winey almost. Pardon me, but would be brilliant with pretty much everything over Christmas, you know. I do digress. Right. What am I on here? Where are we? Oh, here we are. Ardian Hansons. Rockin' Rudolph. It's all right. It's a nice sessionable beer. What sort of ABV? We're talking 4.2, so it's well sessionable ABV. Get a few of them while you're cooking, even, without setting fire to yourself or setting light to your beard and the candles and that. So you can get a few. a bit handy with a leapfrog milch. It's a, you know, good old drinkable beer, but it's not setting fire to me underwear, you know, let alone me beard. It's all right. It's a good beer. It's a nice beer. It's sessionable, but it's not doing it. And if you want a Christmas beer, there's loads of other beers without the Christmas written on the thing. You're buying it. What this is, a lot of these beers are aiming at, is that people buy a beer with Christmas on it for someone that likes beers, and so they'll get that for Christmas, you know. Whereas another beer that will be just as good, if not better, they won't get for Christmas, and they won't get to taste it in there. So it's a good thing to a certain extent, because someone that likes beer. You know, in the generic sense of the term, which usually means McLagers and stuff like that, we'll get that, and then they'll go, "Caw, that's a lot better than what I've been drinking," which it is. It's a much better than McLagers and whatever. But it's just a plain sessionable beer, which is, you know, it's a nice one. It's nice. But I think when you've got Christmas beer, and people are going to get it for Christmas, you want something that's going to go wallop, there you go. That's nice, like that, and it'll kind of bring them back for more. And also, you want something that's going to go with the big flavours of Christmas. You've been eating chocolate all day and munching down cashew nuts and you know, and eating all sorts of sweeties and toffees and, you know, and Christmas puddings, Christmas cake and stuff in your face and all sorts of cranberry sauce on this and... So you want something that's a bit boisterous, mulled wine and God knows what else, and Bailey's Irish cream, and, you know, give us a drop of port, and suddenly you get a beer that's kind of, you know, a bit normal, you know. Now, there's nothing wrong with that at other times of year, but Christmas, come on. Cheers, everyone. Bombs up. Chin chin. Cheers. See you in the next one. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. Don't be late. Yeah,